I'll be coming from is 2 Samuel chapter 11. It happened in the spring of the year, at the time when kings go out to battle, that David sent Joab and his servants with him, and all Israel, and they destroyed the people of Ammon and besieged Rabbah. But David remained at Jerusalem. Then it happened one evening, and I'm coming, that David arose from his bed and walked on the roof of the king's house. And from the roof, he saw a woman bathing, and the woman was very beautiful to behold. Verse 3. So David sent and inquired about the woman. And someone said, "Is this not Bathsheba, the daughter of Eliam, the wife of Uriah the Hittite?" Then David sent messengers and took her, and she came to him, and he lay with her. For she was cleansed from her impurity, and she returned to her house. And the woman conceived. So she sent and told David and said, "I am with child." Then David sent to Joab, saying, "Send me Uriah the Hittite." And Joab sent Uriah to David. And when Uriah had come to him, David asked how Joab was doing, and how the people were doing, and how the war prospered. And David said to Uriah, "Go down to your house and wash your feet." So Uriah departed from the king's house, and a gift of food from the king followed him. But Uriah slept at the door of the king's house with all the servants of his lord, and did not go down to his house. So when they told David, saying, "Uriah did not go down to his house," David said to Uriah, "Did you not come from a journey? Why did you not go down to your house?" And Uriah said to David, "The ark and Israel and Judah are dwelling in tents, and my lord Joab and the servants of my lord are encamped in the open field. Shall I then go to my house and eat and drink and lie with my wife? As you live and as your soul lives, I will not do such a thing." Then David said to Uriah, "Now wait here today also, and tomorrow I will let you depart." So Uriah remained in Jerusalem that day and the next. Now when David called him, he ate and drank before him, and he made him drunk. And at evening he went out to lie in his bed with the servants of his lord. But he did not go down to his house. In the morning it happened that David wrote a letter to Joab and sent it by the hand of Uriah. And he wrote in the letter saying, "Set Uriah in the forefront of the hottest battle, and retreat from him that he may be struck down and die." So it was while Joab besieged the city that he assigned Uriah to a place where he knew that there were valiant men. Then the many men of the city came out and fought with Joab, and some of the people of the servants of David fell, and Uriah the Hittite died also. Skip to verse 26. When the wife of Uriah heard that Uriah, her husband, was dead, she mourned for her husband. And when her mourning was over, David sent and brought her to his house. And she became his wife and bore him a son. But the thing that David had done displeased the Lord. Amen. You may be seated. And think with me for a few minutes on, keep your guard up. Amen. Keep your guard up. And you know, we've been, last time I was here, we talked about David, amen, and how he defeated Goliath. And now this is further down, and he's the king now. Amen. And all these things are happening. But before I get any further in that, I know, you know, again, the thing is, keep your guard up. And somebody may be wondering, what are you talking about? Keep your guard up. Well, you know, I haven't been a chaplain all my life. Amen. I used to be in security forces, enlisted troop, and our senior master sergeant at the time, he was a boxer. You know, and I think he boxed for the Air Force as well. And so, you know, being security forces, you know, I wanted to get all the little knowledge I could to be able to defend myself. And so I got into boxing. It didn't last long because even at that time, even though I wasn't a chaplain, I still was, you know, representing God. And at one And what that means was, you know, when you're in the fight, you know, you gotta have your left and your right up, you know, because if you don't have your left and your right up, and you're in the fight, and you're in the ring with somebody, and you have your guard down, you are subject to get knocked out. Amen. Everybody with me? You're subject to get knocked out. And I'm here to tell you that even though the devil is a defeated foe, amen, he still wants to knock you out. Amen. So he wants, I'm here to tell you today, encourage you to keep your guard up. and they destroyed Judah and besieged Rabbah. But David remained at Jerusalem.